guard can hustle. One night after leading the Mets to a win in Game 3 of the World Series, he's in West Lafayette, Indiana. It's Purdue and Nebraska, a couple of star-crossed teams looking to change their luck. Anish Shroff alongside former Texas Longhorn Ahmad Brooks.
Wow.
These are functional. They keep me warm. You look behind us, though, a black cat. You're holding an upside-down horseshoe, and that's been the season for Nebraska. It's been bad luck, and more bad luck. And just when you think things can't get worse, they do.
Starting quarterback Tommy Armstrong out with a foot injury, which means that now Riker Fife gets the start. This guy has only attempted 7 passes on the year. Now, coaches say the game plan won't change much, but you got to believe it will when the unquestioned leader and the most productive offensive player in Tommy Strong is out of the ballgame.
For Purdue, the Boilers are 1-6. This season has been a horror show. Fans are starting to become no-shows. Darryl Hazel needs to win today.
Yeah, this is important for them. And I can tell you this right now. In order for Darryl Hazel to sell progress that this program is heading in the right direction, he needs this win.
Nebraska won the toss. They defer Purdue to receive. And the Boilermakers will start at their own 25-yard line. Under Darryl Hazel, Purdue just 1-18 in conference games, 0-9 in Big Ten home games, and they're hoping the freshman, David Blau, can deliver a win for these fans here at Ross-Ade Stadium. A 20-year-old redshirt freshman, he took over as the full-time starter in Week 4. Blau to his running back, Markell Jones, on first down. And a nice pickup, a gain of 10 to move the chains. Dedrick Young, the true freshman, on the stop. Markell Jones will get the lion's share of the carries today. DJ Knox, the other running back Purdue uses, out with an ankle injury.
Yeah, and Markell will also be involved in the passing game. Look for him to get involved in ways he just did.
Blau to throw, nothing there, and he's dropped for a loss of a yard. Sacked by Vincent Valentine. This Nebraska defense has been incredibly banged up all season, starting to get somebody's back, but they're thin on the back end of today.
Yeah, they are, but when you have Collins and Valentine up front, does it help a lot, and they've also got a true freshman, number 24, Aaron Williams, making his first start today.
Wow, back to the air here on second down, and a great play there. In space by Aaron Williams. Only a yard. It'll bring up third and long. Williams getting the start. A true freshman in place of Byerson Cockrell, who's attending a family funeral. Cockrell is Nebraska's leading tackler as we come up on third down.
Yeah, but my sources tell me that this kid Williams can play football. He's very athletic, and in the minutes that he has played this year, he's taken advantage of him.
Blau on third down, throwing downfield, and he overthrew D'Angelo Yancey. And the punting unit will come on with Joe Schopper. Back deep for Nebraska, the dangerous DeMornay Pearson L. He missed the first 4 games of the season with a foot injury, but he's a menace back there. 3 punt return touchdowns last year. And somebody jumped.
Offside. Defense number 43. 5-yard penalty remains. Fourth down.
It's Tyron Ferguson. So now 4th and 5. Punt unit still stays on. And Schopper, the freshman from Indianapolis, with what appears to be Halloween shoes, will punt it away. Booming kick. Pearson L will let it bounce. It takes a bounce inside the 5. Kick back, and it'll be down at the 6-yard line. Nebraska this season, 3-5, all five losses by a combined 13 points. Four of those losses on the opponent's final offensive play. And Riker Fife will get the start at quarterback for the Huskers. First career start. He's only thrown 18 career passes. He gets the nod in place of Tommy Armstrong, who's out with an ankle injury.
And this offensive staff thinks that this young man has a quick release, that he sees the field well, and that he's comfortable in the quick passing game. Look for them to make some early throws, short, intermediate throws, to try to get him in a rhythm and make him feel more comfortable at the helm.
Out of the standard eye, the give to Terrell Newby. Expect to see a lot of him today. And he is to the 11-yard line for a gain of four. And on that first defensive set, we saw Purdue's Spartan package. That's when they go five D linemen. You'll see two D ends in there, Jalen Robinson and Antoine Miles, along with three defensive tackles. The Purdue defensive staff said they expect Nebraska to run. That's the counter. First pass from Fife, floats one down the sideline, and it's incomplete, intended for Pearson L. The all-conference DB, Frankie Williams, broke it up. Eight career interceptions for number 24.
And Nebraska trying to take an early shot. Frankie Williams, probably the more solid cover guy on this team for sure. That time there, just couldn't connect. I thought the ball was a little bit underthrown, but Pearson L tried to make a fine effort of hauling in the football for his quarterback.
Purdue really likes its two corners, Anthony Brown and Frankie Williams. Arguably the strength of this Boilermaker defense. Fife on third down, checks down to Pearson L, and he picks up a Nebraska first down across the 20 to the 24-yard line, a gain of a dozen.
Yeah, Pearson L is the guy going into fall camp. This was the feature player they wanted on offense, but when he got banged up and injured, it really set this offense back. And now to see him at the best health he's been at all season long, you can see the difference he can make. And he will be the go-to guy, already targeted twice in the opening drive.
Nebraska without one of its top receivers, Alonzo Moore, today out with a shoulder injury. This time they go to Brandon Riley on the screen. Riley couldn't quite break free. Still picks up a first down, and we say hello to Brendan Fitzgerald.
Hello, Anish. Some breaking news today out of the Big Ten. Ohio State quarterback JT Barrett was cited early this morning for operating a vehicle while intoxicated. He will be suspended for Ohio State's game against Minnesota next Saturday. Back to you, Anish.
Just when he was named the starter. Not bad, though, to have Cardale Jones as your number two. This is Terrell Newby for a gain of a yard. Second down and nine. Andy James Garcia on the stop. Riker Fife, the Nebraska quarterback, didn't exactly have what you would call a French work week the past six, 7 days. He was taking all the first team reps. Tommy Armstrong watched practice in a boot pretty much all week. Here's Riley. Riley into Purdue territory to the 43-yard line as we take a look at our impact players.
Today for me, it's simple. The A and the B gaps. And on this side of the ball, what will happen today is Jordan Westerkamp, is the top target for this team. He will be matched up today on Leroy Clark, one of the more solid safeties in the Big Ten. It's a matchup to follow because Clark believed that he can check any wide receiver man-to-man. And Westerkamp is here to prove that he can.
Westerkamp in the slot on first and 10. Up the middle, Newby. And he's to the 40-yard line for a gain of three. Terrell Newby, a junior out of Los Angeles. And you talk about stepping into size 17s. Amir Abdullah was the feature back in this offense the last few years. And Abdullah now with the Detroit Lions. Back-to-back 1,600-yard seasons before leaving Nebraska.
Yeah, that's a lot of production to replace. And Newby has been in a competition, and I think he really found his rhythm at Minnesota, and the coaching staff has kind of since that time made him the feature and lead back.
Five-man front again for Purdue, the Spartan package. Here's Newby, bounces to the outside. He's got some room. Newby inside the 25 to the 22-yard line before being brought down by Gregory.
Yeah, Newby's got the breakaway speed to hit you with the big one. This time here, the right side of the offensive line doing a nice job. He picks up a great block there from his fullback, Andy Janovich. And you will hear that name a lot here today. But Newby finding space and then finishing off that run with a physical approach to making those guys tackle him.
Purdue with the worst rush defense in the Big Ten, getting up almost 200 yards per game. Now they'll feed Newby once more, and he's to the 20 for a gain of two. Already 48 rushing yards on this drive for Nebraska. When you have a running game, it takes a little pressure off Riker Fife, who's making his first career start.
No question about it. And I think he's gotten his team into the right place. He's checked what he needed to. He's doing a good job on this first drive.
That's Pearsonell, and Purdue blows that one up in the backfield. Jalen Robinson, it's a loss of seven.
And they will. They will run that horizontal motion across the field. And you see here just a jet sweep. Jalen Robinson having none of it. The son of the great big dog, Glenn Robinson, making a play, getting a tackle for loss. And this young man is strong and physical. The coaching staff say he's one of the strongest players on the team. And you can see there, as he just blew by, he's also very athletic and able to track down wide receivers and running backs.
Janovich goes wide. Fife over the middle. That's caught by Riley. He stood up immediately. And it'll bring up fourth down. Drew Brown and the kicking unit will come on for Nebraska to try to get three. This is about a 41-yarder for Drew Brown. Hit two from beyond 40 last week, and he's made eight straight from between 40 and 50. And the sophomore out of Southlake, Texas, gives Nebraska the lead, a 12-play 70-yard drive, capped by a field goal. Hello to the Avengers. Mike Riley and Darrell Hazel could sure use an avenging angel, given the way the seasons for Nebraska and Purdue have gone. Huskers up 3-0 after getting a field goal on their opening drive.
Nebraska scored on their opening drive each of the last three games. They are usually off to a fast start, and they are here again today.
There's Danny Anthrop across the 20-yard line, and he's to the 23. And that's where Purdue will start
it every week. Great.
There's David Blau, the redshirt freshman, making his fifth start. And offensive coordinator John Shoup said this Boilermaker offense has to get him into a rhythm. Blau looking, nobody there. And he's tackled right at the line of scrimmage. That looked like a coverage sack. Ross DeZuris got him.
Yeah, I don't know if it was considered a sack, but he got a yard on it. And actually, that was the best he could do there, because downfield, there was no one open. None of the wide receivers had separated from the defensive backs.
It's a good sign from a Nebraska pass defense that hasn't been very good this season. Designed quarterback run. And Blau out to the 28-yard line for a gain of four. We were told we would see more of those today.
Yeah, for me, Blau is a good athlete. And you just need to take advantage of his running ability. And there you saw it. And it managed to get them a third and short situation because they went with a design quarterback draw. And they will do more of that, as you said, this week.
Blau dumps it off. He's got Yancey. And Yancey Or rather, Markell Jones able to pick up a first down, second catch for Jones.
Yeah, both Knox and Jones are used out of the backfield, but what was impressive about that last play is Blau got his head around soon enough to avoid the pressure and get the ball and the outlet to Jones. That's a savvy play from a young man still looking for his first win as a starter.
Blau looking, and he's dropped by Malik Collins, big number 7, an all-conference defensive tackle, and boy, does he have the attention of the Purdue offensive coaches.
This kid is just smooth. I mean, to be as large as he is and to move the way that he does, the mobility, the agility, and the physicality in which he plays with, he's one of the best defensive tackles in all of the country, and you'll see him today wreak some havoc.
Blau off the play fake. Nothing doing. Cam Posey got maybe a couple. And another third down coming for Purdue. Joshua Kalu was right there.
And this passing defense for Nebraska has not been good on the year, but early on in this ball game, you've seen tight coverage and good open field tackling. That's one way to right the wrongs and the mistakes that they've had all season long.
It's been a schizophrenic defense for Nebraska. Top 10 nationally against the run, bottom 3
Amazing.
Against the pass. Stack receivers to each side here on 3rd and 5. Quarterback draw. Blau's got the first down and more. Blau off to the races. Can he be caught? Touchdown, Purdue!
What a run by the young quarterback from Texas. This young man, you know, that's not something they've shown a lot, as we've said. So this Nebraska staff is going to have to make some adjustments. Typically, when they've tried to get the quarterback involved with the run game, it's been from the zone read with passing options off of it. But they went back during the bye week, self-evaluated, and said, we need to change that because teams are really sniffing that play out. So they've gone more to the design quarterback draws like you just saw Blau score on that one.
Darrell Hazel told us yesterday his team needed explosive plays. He said he wanted at least 10 plays in this game of 15 or more yards.
Offside.
Well, that was
defense
a big one.
Number 55. Unless half the distance of the goal line remains to try.
And what that play doesn't show you, yeah, you see the touchdown, obviously, in the scoreboard. But what it also does is it gives Blau enough confidence to come back out here and feel like he can lead his team up and down the field and score on this Nebraska defense.
Offside. Defense number 23 on the bend to the backfield. Penalized half the distance to the goal line. Remains to try.
Too early to think about maybe going for 2 as you continue to inch up.
Yeah,
right?
I was watching Hazel on that play. Was he going to do it or not? The coach going with the wise decision here to get the extra point.
Kick by Griggs is good. Purdue on the board with a boom. Blau, a 56-yard touchdown run. See Harley Quinn in there. I think that's the guy at the end from V from Vendetta. These are some of the relatives of our crew members
Adorable.
And folks getting dressed up here at Raw State Stadium as well. Hello, Uncle Sam. You did not get a costume for Halloween.
I did not. I'm sorry about that. I hate to disappoint you, buddy.
Newbie from the 9. Dropped at the 20-yard line. Let's go back to the Purdue touchdown.
Yeah, I just want you to watch it here as we run the play. It's just simple blocking up front that breaks this play. Look at the hole that is created as Blau goes for the run. I want you to watch the next big block right here. The crack block by Dominique Young, which is what broke the play wide open and allowed him to go the distance. It was blocking, not just the athleticism of Blau, that put the Boilermakers in the end zone.
Second to drive now for Nebraska. Riker Fife, the junior from Grand Island in Nebraska, making his first career start. A walk-on, a former walk-on. They'll give it to Newby as Pearson L came around on that fake sweep. And Newby able to pick up four. Six carries, 32 yards for Newby here in the first quarter. Is Newby, and he picks up three more. We get an update from Brendan. Well, Ahmad, we saw Syracuse and Pitt last week, and I know you're a big fan of their quarterback, Eric Dungy.
He's legit, if you ask me.
Fife struggled with the snap, able to recover, and fires to Westerkamp. And it appears Westerkamp has enough for a first down. Crowd not thrilled with the spot.
Yeah, but I think when you go back and you look at it, the way that Fife just handled himself, he bobbles the snap, somehow manages to throw the football, whether with laces or without, and threw it in an accurate location, which helped him move the chains. Those are the plays that this junior quarterback has to do to prove that he can be the man and come away here today with a victory.
22 straight games with a catch for Westerkamp. Newby could not MacGyver his way out of that one, and it's a loss of three.
Yeah, and that was not a good read there by Newby. He had the cutback available to him, and he just kept running the direction where the Purdue defenders were piling up. I know when he looks at that and he watches film of that, he's going to tell himself, if I'd have cut back, we'd have gotten some positive yards. Now you put yourself behind the chains here with a second and long.
Fife dumps it off. He's got Newby. Breaks the tackle, and Newby surges ahead, and he's going to be close to another first down for the Huskers. He's got it.
That's great execution there on the running back screen by Nebraska. And Fife also throwing a ball in here with pressure in his face. Replogle trying to get to him, and Newby, boy, he just didn't want to come down on that one. He's known for his speed, but the young man there showing physical toughness and fight to get to the first down marker.
Fife, five out of six in the early going. And to talking to Mike Riley before the game, he's got a lot of confidence in this young man. Pearson L motions, play action, fight, downfield, Westerkamp makes the catch for another Huskers first down.
The second ball in a row where I've seen this young man use some touch. Great protection up front from the offensive line. And Westerkamp, one of the best route runners in the Big Ten, creates the separation there on Roberts and is able to get open. And Fife finding what has been the favorite target for this offense for some time, Westerkamp.
Westerkamp top 10 at Nebraska all time in receptions and receiving yards. Spartan package for Purdue. Imani Cross dragging a tackler to the 35. Garrett Hudson, the son of defensive coordinator Greg Hudson, with the stop. This has been a problem for Purdue on the season. They give up 2.8 yards after contact. That is the worst mark amongst Power 5 teams.
You said it, Anish, because when you look at this team early on in the year, they struggled making the basic tackle and doing the fundamentals. They've really cleaned that up. As you've seen, that number has decreased and dropped, but still something they're working on here at Purdue.
Newby looking to escape the ambush, and he's able to get a yard out of all that. So third down now for Nebraska. Got the ball at about the 34-yard line.
Yeah, Daryl Hazel wanted his team to be more aggressive. And what does that mean for the defensive side of the ball? More negative plays and making sure that you can get off the field in these types of situations on third down.
High snap over the head of Fife. Ball is still loose. Picked up by Purdue. Hudson finally tripped up inside the 20.
And when you look back at this play, there's going to be a player that stands out to me in terms of effort and doing the right thing. Jalen Robinson does exactly what you're coached to do. In these types of situations, you've got to separate the ball carrier from the ball. And he did exactly that, which allowed his teammates, there's four defenders near the football, to pick the football up. Those are the things that you coach during the week. And if you're Purdue, it's good to see them translate to the football field. It tells you the players are listening. And boy, do they have momentum after a big turnover. And now give this offense excellent field position.
Purdue will take over in the red zone. First and 10 from the 16. Toss to Markell Jones. And Mr. Football in the state of Indiana last year is dropped for a loss. Josh Banderas, the Mike linebacker, on the stop. And that will be the final play of quarter number one. Purdue wanted explosive plays. They got one on offense. And now the defense comes up with one here. Now the Purdue cheerleaders. I'm not sure they carved those pumpkins, but whoever did, we have a lot of credit. That's an art form.
No doubt. And I'm digging the music too, by the way. Can we keep that all year round? I'd like to.
The spook story music?
Yeah, I'm digging it. I'm digging it.
Second and 11 for Purdue in Nebraska territory after a turnover. Lau on the bootleg, throwing on the run. And that is a catch inside the 5-yard line. It's the redshirt freshman business major, Cole Herdman.
Tom, here, you just see it. Some people refer to that as a waggle boot. But doing a nice job there of getting outside, and he recognized the throw early. Blau has really been in rhythm today, and that's something that this coaching staff believe, that this young man has a high ceiling and that he has the potential to play at this level.
First and goal for Purdue after the catch by Herdman. Blau under pressure, and he's got to throw it away. He faked the toss, and Nebraska was breathing right down his neck. Dedrick Young was in his face.
Yeah, and that was a great angle to be able to pull him up and force him to have to throw the ball away. He took the proper angle. You've got to go high on that and not allow him to get outside and contain. And that's exactly what the Nebraska defense did on that play.
Posey and Anthrop, the slot receivers, on second and goal. Blau is going to try to run for it again, and he is stood up. Dedrick Young has had a nice first half for Nebraska.
Stood up. He's crushed on this play. I mean, I heard this way up here. Listen to the sound on this. Oh, my. And Blau turned right into one of those black shirts. And Mr. Young made him pay for it as he ran the proper angle and a nice job there of filling the football and getting to the right position.
Young, a true freshman from Peoria, Arizona. And we've got a timeout here on third and goal. We'll step aside. 13:54 to go, first half. It's no secret, Daryl Hazel is on the hot seat. 1-6 this season, his third season. Only 2 wins against FBS programs through 3 years. And he told us, in a game like this, they're going to be aggressive, third and goal from the three. This could be four down territory for the Boilers.
Yeah, I think you're right, because what it does do, even if you turn the ball over here, you really do have good field position for your defense to come out here and make a play.
Blau looking, flushed, throws one into the end zone, and it's caught for a touchdown. Danny Anthrop with his second TD grab of the season. And what looked like a dangerous throw works out for the Boilermakers.
I couldn't agree with you more. And Anthrop there deserves a lot of credit, because he went and found the football. This ball didn't look like it was necessarily thrown to him.
It almost found
but
a white jersey.
And got it at its highest point, and that's a fine catch there as Purdue scores on a big third down inside of the five.
And that's the third time Nebraska has jumped on a PAT.
Offside. Defense number 95 moving into the neutral zone, causing the offensive player to react. Penalized half the distance to the goal line, remains the try.
Jack Gangwish a bit too eager. That's got to feel good for Danny Anthrop. It was against Nebraska last year that he tore his ACL and he missed the rest of the season. It happened in November. And his Purdue offense was never really the same down the stretch.
We're looking for a throw here from Blau to Anthrop. You see it here. Nothing really happening, but he's moving to his right. And for right-handed quarterbacks, that's the most comfortable position you can be in. But you know what helps this play the most? Anthrop. Look at his ability right there to just snatch the ball out of the air in front of Nate Gary, who had the better position. But boy, that was a big-time play for this Purdue program.
When we spoke to Darrell Hazel yesterday, he did not hide from it. He said this team needs a win. They need a win in this building, 0-9 in Big Ten home games under Darrell Hazel. And he has to show progress for this fan base.
I really like his demeanor. But at the end of the day, everybody is judged on their production. And when you look at these numbers, they're not very good. And I know he took over a program that needed some help and needed some changes.
And still does.
Absolutely. And it was interesting talking to both Coach Riley and Coach Hazel this week about how difficult the transition can be. When you take a job on, you don't know what you're dealing with necessarily in terms of talent and what's the best scheme. And you've got to get here to be able to figure that out. And they're still trying to find their way.
There's Stanley Morgan running it out of his end zone. Morgan sheds a couple of tacklers. Stiff arms his way to the 42, and we have another update from Brendan. Penn State 3-1 in the Big Ten East. Nebraska getting a spark from its kick return unit that had struggled all season. Good starting field position for Mike Riley's Huskers. Fife slings one over the middle to Westerkamp, and he's into Purdue territory to the 44, a gain of 14.
I'm willing to say that was the best throw he's made in his career, because then he's only had 18 attempts. The way that he threw that ball in, he used a very different arm slot, almost like a sidearm pitcher, and was able to really squeeze that in into a tight window because the defensive line did a good job of trying to obstruct his passing lanes.
Newby off tackle into the secondary. Newby churning inside the 25 before Garcia made the tackle, a gain of 21.
I'm more impressed with what Fife did at the line of scrimmage. He checked the playoff, sent a wide receiver in motion to open up this run for Newby. And what it did is he caught Purdue in man-to-man coverage and made them minus one on that side of the field when he sent the wide receiver in motion. It looked like he checked that playoff. Fife is a coach's son. He's got a great understanding of football, and you saw it just there.
Fife to the air. He wants Riley. It's broken up by Anthony Brown.
Fife pass incomplete, intended for Riley.
And the timing may have been a tad bit late here, but the wide receiver has to do a much better job of going to the football. Brandon Riley, perhaps one of the best wide receivers on this team and one of the more consistent guys, and they really believe they've got wide receiver depth, but that's one of those plays. You've got to help your quarterback, and you've got to go to the football in situations like that.
Divine Ojigbo checks into the game at running back for the first time. Pearson L in motion. Ojigbo, freshman, trying to change directions. And he's to the 20-yard line, just the second catch of the season for Ojigbo.
Yeah, and that was an excellent effort on the part of the defensive line. Evan Panfield did a great job of tracking the football down, and it's hard for those big guys that sometimes can be slugs in the middle of the field to chase down some of the more athletic players on the field. But Purdue doing a nice job of pursuing the football and then open field tackling. That was the key to that play.
DeJuan Hunt comes in for Purdue as the fifth defensive back. Nickel look for the Boilers. Fife on third down, near sideline. That's caught. Morgan. Touchdown, Nebraska! There is a player down in the end zone, and that is DeMornay Pearson-L, who's already missed four games this year with a foot injury.
That is not the guy that this Nebraska team nor the Cornhusker fans are hoping goes down. He's finally getting to the best health of the season. This is a young man as one of the more dynamic returners in all of the country, and they've done a good job of moving him around early on, but missed tackles here is what really hurt this defense. As you see there, one on the cornerback, one on the safety, and it looked like he kept himself in bounds. And if his knee was down here, it looks like, I don't see it from this angle, it looks like he kept his feet, put the arm down. That's a fine job of making things happen there. Stanley Morgan, freshman for this Nebraska team. And like I said, they've got depth here at the wide receiver position. Despite having one of your top players down right now in Pearson-L, they really are comfortable with the guys that are there.
Yeah, it's one of the deeper positions on this team, and it was a little surprising last week in the Northwestern game. Uncharacteristic. There were a lot of drops.
Yep.
Riley almost had a touchdown. He couldn't hold on, and Morgan's a guy who's going to see more snaps today with Alonzo Moore out. Morgan already this year had one of the biggest catches of the season for Nebraska. That was in the Miami game. He had the game-tying touchdown catch at the end of regulation. Nebraska, though, would fall in overtime, and that has been another recurring theme for the Huskers in 2015.
Yeah, and to your point on those drops, you know, we spoke to the coaching staff and asked them, you know, and they said this has been a lot of different things, timing, ball placement, focus, wide receivers snapping their eyes around at the appropriate time. He said it's like being in a slump in baseball. You just got to keep working through the details to find a breakthrough. And as you see the stretcher pull out,
that's not a good sign.
This is not a good sign for this young man.
Now, we're told the injury was maybe a little too graphic, so I don't think we're going to show that, how it happened. Oh, yikes. Yeah, we can see the replay up here in the booth, and his left knee just buckles. It is gruesome to look at. And that's not a good sign for DeMornay Pearson-L. He has already missed four games with a foot injury. He's a dynamic playmaker and a big part of this punt return unit as well.
Yeah, and once again, this Nebraska coaching staff is back at square one, where you've started to incorporate him back into the offense and make him your feature guy, and he's down again. So the key for me moving forward is going to be, how does this Nebraska staff adjust without having him in the ball game? And I just talked about the depth they have at wide receiver. They're hoping right now that they can have some guys step up and replace the production that this young man is capable of having.
Much has been made about the heartbreak Nebraska has suffered at the end of games. The other narrative this season has been injuries. They have been decimated with some key injuries at key positions, more so on the defensive side of the ball. But DeMorne Pearsonell was a guy, when Mike Riley got to Lincoln, he said Pearsonell reminded him of Brandon Cooks, who was a Biletnikoff Award winner at Oregon State. They thought they could use him all over the field. And to your point, they had all these packages for him, but because he got hurt early, they just couldn't install them. They were now just getting to those packages.
Yeah, and injuries, as you said, have been a problem. This team offensively has started 20 starters, and they've started 20 starters on defense. I mean, so it's been a team that has had a revolving door with their starters.
Point after is blocked. Nebraska scores, and one of their top players gets carted off. Purdue leading Nebraska 14-9 here in the first half. Mike Riley already without starting quarterback Tommy Armstrong today. He's out with an ankle injury. And on that last drive, on that last touchdown by the Huskers, one of Riley's top playmakers, DeMorne Pearsonell, was carted off the field. Danny Anthrop glides across the 30-yard line. In its 11th year sponsoring the Good Hands Field Goal Nets, Allstate makes contributions to participating universities' general scholarship funds for each field goal and extra point kicked. To date, Allstate has contributed millions in scholarship money. Last point after by Nebraska blocked. First missed PAT in Drew Brown's career. Wow, all day. He'll take a shot downfield for Yancey. Incomplete. Coverage there by Nate Gary.
Yeah, and if you're Blau, this is all you can do. You can just give your wide receiver an opportunity in one-on-one coverage. And in talking to this staff earlier in the week, it was clear. The offense coordinator, John Shoup, said, we are going to take shots downfield. But more importantly, we've got to win one-on-one matchups. They'll want that one back when they look at it.
Jones up the middle. He's tackled by Kevin Maurice, who's back after missing three games with a foot injury. You'll hear us saying that about a lot of Nebraska defensive players. Third down for Purdue from inside the 35. Purdue has converted 34% on third down this season. Anthrop motions. Blau rolling to his right. Throwing on the run. That's broken up by Jones, but a flag.
Great coverage. Fortunately, it looks like pass interference on Nebraska here.
Prior to the pass being thrown, holding defense number three. The foul occurred against an eligible receiver. 10-yard penalty, automatic. First down.
That's Marcus Newby, the sophomore out of Maryland. And the penalty will give Purdue a first down.
That hurts right there. Right side of your screen here, you'll see him right here is where the holding occurred. And any time you have a linebacker on a wide receiver, they're more inclined to hold because they're not as athletic. And that time, that was a bad matchup for Nebraska defense.
Jones looking for the edge, cuts it back, elbow down as he gets across the 45, and there is a flag back at the 43.
Holding, offense, number 72, 10-yard penalty, repeat first down.
Jason King, who's making his 25th straight start, called that time.
And give it right back if you're Purdue. You pick up good yardage on a penalty on a third down. Now, once again, you're in a first and long situation. A lot of times offensive coordinators like to go with a run here to try to get some of that yardage back.
Wow's pass is caught off the tip by one of the linemen. It's the center, Robert Kugler.
That is awesome. I mean, what?
An eligible receiver on the offense touched the ball first, therefore, offensive lineman is eligible.
That is just awesome. Now, he was eligible to catch that football, and that's what the official was saying, because it went off the hands first. But if you're an offensive lineman, you know, talk about trick or treat. Today's Halloween, that was a treat for him. Big boy got an opportunity to show his skills. That was fantastic. Can we see that again?
You had him as one of your impact players, right?
I did.
You were not expecting that sort of impact.
That wasn't the impact I was expecting. It was more so trying to handle number 98, Vincent Valentin up front, and also Malik Collins. These two guys are grown men. And as you can see, the big smile there, the big fella. Yeah, look, I guarantee you, he won't hear the end of that one for the rest of the year. The guys in the offensive line meeting room are going to harass him forever. Now he's talking about, oh, did you see how fast I was going? Yeah, the story just keeps growing.
Yeah, paragon of grace and symmetry there by Kugler.
That's 6'3", great.
294
the ball
was touched
only by a member of the offense. Therefore, it's a foul through an illegal touching.
Oh, man.
By an eligible receiver on the offense. That's a 5-yard penalty from the previous spot. See, first down.
All right, let's take one more look. Originally, it looked like that ball was first tipped by Markell Jones. See if we can find out what happens here.
Wow. So it doesn't look like it touches any Nebraska player. Interesting. You know, from the first view we saw, it looked like both players, both Jones and the defender Young, got a hand on this. But looking back on the replay, it does look like only Young was able to touch the football.
And they're still trying to sort things out.
Here's what the officials are looking at. So it has to be touched by a Nebraska player. And here it looks like it's only Jones. And if that is the case, it's going to come back.
And is that hit? Dedrick Young, number 5 in white.
It didn't appear from the angles we have, and it'll be interesting to see. And then also, number 98, Valentine, also had an opportunity. It looked like it might have went off of his hand as well, but I didn't see the ball change in terms of the projection of it. And that being said, that's usually when you can tell a ball has been tipped or not.
If the defensive player tips it, that's fair game then for Kugler. And at first glance, it looked like it definitely got Jones, and it did. And there were a couple of white shirts, and it looked like it may have glanced off of somebody else. Your magic loogie theory, if you will.
And this is going to be a tough call here for the referee, Don Willard, as he's calling up top to try to get a better look at it and for the replay officials. But
if the defense does not touch it, that would make Kugler ineligible.
Now, don't envy their job in situations like this.
Said before in this broadcast how important this game was for Purdue and Daryl Hazel. Daryl Hazel told us this would be a resounding win. It's of equal importance for a Nebraska team that is looking to get to the postseason. The Huskers are 3-5. They've got to go 3-1 the rest of the way to become bowl eligible. And I'm sure Mike Riley and his staff, and certainly the Nebraska fans, probably circle this one as a W before the season and maybe even before the week.
You're probably right. And, you know, the FBI also wasn't favorable towards Purdue in this situation. But at the end of the day, you still have to play the games. And now you see it. Purdue's up.
After further review, the ruling on the field is confirmed. Only an offensive player touched it prior to the offensive lineman touching it. Therefore, it is a foul for illegal touching. It's a 5-yard penalty. We'll repeat first down.
And Kugler's smile like that is evaporated, as does the indent he made in the box score.
No question.
Now, he might be hiding a smile behind the mouth guard.
Oh, boy, it's still something to brag about, too.
First into 25 now. Four-man rush, Blau to Jones. And he's down at the 31 in the gain of two. And this is where Purdue misses DJ Knox. Knox, aside from splitting the load in the backfield with Jones, was the better receiver of the two, 20 catches. And he was a guy that was able to do some things in the passing game.
Yeah, but Jones is also top four receiver for this football team, too. So this is a team that uses both of their backs. And that last time there, Blau slapped himself in the helmet because he got that ball off a tad bit late.
Little pop pass to Anthrop. He gives it back the other way. And that is Jarrett Burgess with a nice pickup, a gain of 14. The 25-year-old freshman who was a former minor league baseball player.
Here go the shots they were talking about, a double or jet sweep reverse where they bring Burgess back, with who's blazing fast, to get on the outside. And that was a great job of him of making the first guy miss, because that could have been a dangerous play that would have resulted in more yard loss of yardage, but he manages to get through, and now a third and manageable situation.
At least compared to what it was, 9 yards to go. Wow, pass downfield and a little too high. Intended for Hart, and it's fourth down.
And after having momentum, Purdue offense coming out and scoring, and they also created some points on defense. They've been a tad bit stagnant here in the second quarter as they're looking to find their rhythm.
Nebraska's top punt returner, Demorne Pearson-L, was carted off the field earlier in the quarter. So it's Westerkamp back deep. And he watches this one go out of bounds. Huskers get the ball back with 9 minutes to go in the half. Of our crew celebrating Halloween. Alongside Ahmad Brooks and Ish Schropp, we're in West Lafayette, Purdue, leading Nebraska 14-9. Boilermakers trying to snap a 5-game losing streak. Nebraska looking to bounce back from a loss to Northwestern a week ago. Riker Fife making his first career start at QB for the Huskers. Little trouble on the exchange, and Fife dropped. Back at the 7 by Garrett Hudson. It's a loss of 8.
Yeah, they were trying some trickery here to try to get a reverse on the backside and just completely misses it. It looks like Fife there was a tad bit late on getting it out after trying to hold the ball fake. And then it didn't look like the wide receiver also took the appropriate angle. You've got to help your quarterback there and get to your spot.
Now, there's a good chance that normally would have been Pearson L, who was carted off earlier
point.
In this half. Fife in traffic, incomplete. They wanted his tight end, Seathan Carter. And it's going to be 3rd and 18 from the 7.
Man, Howard blew that thing up. 6'3", 310 pounds from Asbury Park, New Jersey.
Greetings from Asbury Park.
No question about it. That's a big man there, and that's the last guy you want to see when you're trying to run a tunnel screen back to the middle of the field. Comes the pressure.
Fife running for his life. And he's driven out of bounds, and Nebraska will punt from deep in its own zone. Now, Darrell Hazel told us Part of the aggressiveness for Purdue today will involve coming after some kicks. Another injured Nebraska player. Jordan Westerkamp is down at the 30, and that is a loss Mike Riley can ill afford.
It's a starting quarterback, Tommy Armstrong, already out. You lose Pearson L. Moore's out. And now, perhaps your most talented wide receiver could be out of this ball game potentially as well. This is the kind of season that Nebraska's had this year, and you hope Westerkamp is okay. But it looked like he got mixed up in a block, and as we'll watch it here, and just gets tangled up. And, you know, these are just unfortunate circumstances. He takes a hit there, and it looked like maybe the inside of that left knee was maybe banged up, but that is tough.
Westerkamp, a captain. Top 10 all-time at Nebraska in receptions and receiving yards. And he's got some of the best hands in all of college football.
Couldn't agree with you more. And then when you watch him run routes, the way that he separates and the things that he does at the top of his route to beat defenders let you know that this young man has a future if he decides. Here's what he's been able to do today when you look at Westerkamp. A conversion there on a third down. Watch his routes and his ability to get underneath there. He opened that up for his quarterback by the way he ran his route. And then here on a slant route, doing a nice job of securing the catch, falling forward for another first down. Westerkamp is the top target here for this Nebraska team. That would be a big hit if he's no longer able to come back out here and play.
First punt for Nebraska, Sam Fultz in his own end zone. Here come the Boilermakers. Fultz gets it off. Frankie Williams will let it bounce. And Nebraska will down it in Purdue territory as we check in with Brendan.
Of getting Blau on the move. And we talked to him earlier in the week, and they said this kid is athletic. He's athletic enough to make plays with his feet, but I also think he's much more comfortable on the move. So that time there, the last two of time that he's been on a boot, though, he hasn't been as accurate passing the football. It looks like he's a little bit anxious. They'll try to settle him down on the sideline.
Morgan with a fair catch at the 6-yard line after a 44-yard punt by Joe Schopper. Small step for man, one giant leap for mankind. The words of Purdue alumnus and the first man on the moon, Neil Armstrong. July 1969, he set foot on the moon. He's got a fan club here in West Lafayette. Monty Cross to the 11-yard line for Nebraska, and I wonder, the Huskers go back to the run. It worked so well on that first drive.
Yeah, but they've also put themselves in some bad positions. Last drive, you get behind the sticks with penalties, and now it's hard to run the football. So they've got to put themselves in good positions to be able to run the football and for that to be an option. And they started this drive off getting good productive yardage, 4 yards a pop on the ground. Any offensive coordinator, any offensive team in the country would desire that.
Jordan Westerkamp back in the game for Nebraska. He's lined up in the slot.
False start. Offense, number 87. 5-yard penalty. Repeat, second down.
That's the wide receiver, Brandon Riley, so here again behind the chains.
And that's exactly what I was saying. It's hard to rush the football and get into a rhythm for the running back or for the offense when you keep setting yourself back with silly penalties.
Yeah. by in trouble hit as he throws it. Is it picked off by Brown? It is. There was a flag on the play in the end zone. Fife threw it up. Anthony Brown with the diving INT.
Holding. Offense, number 70.
Wow.
That penalty is declined. The result of the play is an interception. First down, Purdue.
Jalen Robinson is the one that makes this play. He's going to start on the left defensive end position. It's on the outside. He runs a simple twist, blows by the center and the guard in the A-gap, and chases down the quarterback. And how about this for an effort? To lay out, put it all on the line. Anthony Brown, the cornerback from Tampa, Florida, doing a fine job of securing that catch. And this Purdue offense is set up with short field. Now, can they make it work for them?
Second career pick for Brown. And if you're Darrell Hazel, you look at the scoreboard, you've got to be thinking, we've got to be up by more than 14-9. Pressure from up the middle. Blau finds Anthrop, and he's to the 14-yard line, close to the first down, about a yard and a half shy.
Yeah, and Blau really put his whole body into that throw as he zipped it out there. One of the harder throws to make outside the numbers, but he made it look easy.
Second and two. Jones up the gut, and he's got a first down for Purdue. Purdue has already scored a touchdown off of one Nebraska turnover. This is Jones again. He's inside the five. Second and goal for Purdue.
One thing you've noticed here is Purdue is starting to slow the pace of the game down. Early on, they were going up-tempo offense. But here, it's so valuable, once you get inside the red zone, to make sure you're calling the right play and that your players understand the game plan.
Back to Jones. He is engulfed for no gain. Aaron Williams, the freshman safety, on the stop. Third and goal. Under Darrell Hazel, Purdue has won just one Big Ten game in 19 tries. That was last year against Illinois. It's Purdue's only win against a Power 5 school under Hazel. And Hazel uses a timeout with 4:16 to go. Third and goal, Purdue knocking on the door. Make sure to download the Watch ESPN app. You can follow all your favorite games throughout the college football season. And remember, it is free to download. Third and goal for Purdue. Boilermakers looking to capitalize on a short field after an interception by Riker Fife. A little misdirection and a touchdown by Dominique Young.
Great vision. Squeezing a little crease there. We're going to see it. This defense had him outflanked. He ended up losing contain. And Young makes some play.
A trick and a treat for Purdue as they have a 20-9 lead, looking to tack on one more. Darrell Hazel said he wanted explosive plays from offense, defense, and special teams, and he's had those today.
Yeah, this is just an impact play right here. You see the pressure. As Robinson got to him and they turn it in, Brown with an interception. What does it turn into? Points. What a creative play call here at the end. And the Nebraska defense just overruns the football. But watch how the hole opens up here. That was Young with great vision, an ability to plant, cut, get inside of that crease. And now look at the score, 21-9. Who would have ever thought that Purdue would be up by this much going into the second half?
Especially if you watched how Purdue has played the last couple of games. The Boilermakers are off a bye week. They've worked on a few things. And Darryl Hazel has got to feel good. 21-9. He's looking for his first Big Ten home win as the Boilermakers head coach.
He also said, too, the energy in practice has been phenomenal for this Purdue team this week.
Stanley Morgan, the freshman. He's to the 19-yard line, an 18-yard return. And here's Brendan. All right, we look forward to halftime. 4:07 to go here in the second quarter. Nebraska has been plagued by a couple of turnovers. Starting quarterback Tommy Armstrong out with an ankle injury, and it's Riker Fife and his first career start under center. Out of the eye, Imani Cross devoured for a loss. Jake Replogle led the charge for Purdue.
And they like Cross's change of pace. He's got more of a power style of running. And that time there was nothing in the middle of that defense as Purdue doing a nice job of reestablishing the line of scrimmage and forcing him to run right into just a myriad of Boilermaker defenders.
Play action. Fife. He'll have to tuck it and run. And he awkwardly slides down at the 28-yard line, a gain of 7. So third and about 4.
And this has been a distance that this Nebraska team has struggled mightily with on third and short situations. They've actually done better on third and long situations. And so this is something that they've got to clean up if they have another challenge today. With a third and short situation, how will they handle it?
Fife over the middle to Morgan. And a great tackle in space. That's going to be short of the first down, so fourth down for the Huskers. Leroy Clark with the tackle for the Boilers.
That was an excellent open field tackle by Leroy Clark. And his swag and confidence continues to grow, and this coaching staff said the kid from Miami, Florida, he just plays with a tremendous amount of confidence. And you can, when you make plays like that, you come across, you fight through traffic, and you manage to bring down a ball carrier short of the first down.
Foltz to punt it away. Frankie Williams back at the 35 for Purdue. This is way over Williams' head. He'll let it bounce. It takes a Nebraska bounce and down at the 12. Been there in all three phases for the Boilermakers. You got the explosive play from the offense, a 56-yard touchdown run by the quarterback, David Blau. That set the tone.
It did. Great blocking up front. And then here you see the defense, opportunistic. Jalen Robinson doing a fine job of separating the quarterback, leads to points. Then they block an extra point. And then defense coming up big with a turnover. Those takeaways so key to getting confidence, getting the ball back to your offense. And you see it in the score as Purdue is up 21-9. They've done a fine job early on in this ball game of controlling the game and making sure they can protect the lead.
Field position is key too. This drive notwithstanding, Purdue's average starting field position was their own 49. For Nebraska, the Huskers own 19. Here's Gregory Phillips on the catch.
And here's where the rhythm is going to pick up in 2 minutes.
Yancey comes back to it and gets out of bounds. No gain on the play, third and two.
And in these third down situations, here's where Nebraska likes to go man-to-man on the edges. And if you are Purdue, you're looking to win those one-on-one matchups and convert the first.
Blau's going to take a shot downfield. Yancey had a step, but the ball was overthrown. John Shoup told us, hey, third and three, third and four, if we see man, we may take a shot. They had a shot there.
Yeah, and Blau is disgusted with himself because these are the types of plays. Fine job of being physical by Yancey to get off. And he's got four or five steps on both of the defenders. That was a play where they've got to win, and you saw Blau just walking off in disgust, knowing they missed a big opportunity to put more points on the board.
All right, Ahmad, now if you're Nebraska, you've got a chance. Two timeouts. If you can get this around the 35, 40-yard line, you've got a chance now to maybe make this a one-score game before halftime. Fair catch signal. Westerkamp makes it at the 37. More college football later to 10 West.
A lot of pressure on number 17, Riker Fife. And if you're a quarterback, these are the moments you live for. For the pressure to be on you, the ball in your hand, with you trying to lead your team down to score.
There's the Spartan front for Purdue. Pressure from up the middle. Fife has to get rid of it. Dangerous throw, nearly picked again. That was Leroy Clark who almost had it.
Ill-advised throw, and the pressure here from Hudson comes right up the middle, untouched. The running back misses a block. Leroy Clark covering one of the better wide receivers in the Big Ten and making it look easy from the safety position. And I told you, that was my matchup to follow going into the impact players. He'll be covering Westerkamp for the majority of the game today.
Four-man twist. Five pump fakes, sidearms one, and he's got his tight end Carter for a first down in Purdue territory. 14 on the play.
That was great patience. He didn't give up on the play, kept his eyes downfield. A lot of times when you don't have a lot of experience, your first tendency is to run. That time there, he stands tall, completes a nice throw for a first down. Wide receiver gets out of bounds. They save a timeout. That is a productive play during 2 minutes.
He's a better athlete than you might think, but he's not Tommy Armstrong with his feet in the pocket. Clock stopped with 107. Over the middle, Westerkamp open. The throw was behind him. That's one Westerkamp usually catches, but I put that one on the quarterback.
Yeah, it was thrown behind, but from the looks of it here, it looked like he might have had to throw it in that particular window because it was clouded to the front part of that route. And Westerkamp, you know, when you're a wide receiver and a ball hits your hand, it doesn't matter. And this is a young man that's caught a lot of footballs as a Cornhusker. He's going to know that he should have caught that football.
He caught one behind his back last year against FAU. Fife downfield. He wants Hubby. Intercepted. Out of the hands of Hubby, into the hands of Brown. Third turnover for Nebraska. Second pick of the half for the senior from Tampa.
Can you say hello, SportsCenter top 10? That was fantastic as you check this play out right here. I mean, it's just great concentration. He's in the right place. Fife trying to throw it up for his wide receiver. And he just doesn't give up on the play. And when you're a competitor playing at the cornerback position, clearly looked like he got his feet established in bounds. This is a big-time play. SportsCenter top 10, nice breakup. And then the concentration and focus to be able to haul it in. Purdue really finding a rhythm defensively as they've created three turnovers today, and it's really helped this offense get a rhythm going.
How aggressive will Darryl Hazel be with a minute to go in this first half?
Yeah, I think you take some shots, especially during sudden change, and that means when you get the ball, when there's some type of turnover, offenses and teams like to take a shot downfield when that happens.
Remember, Nebraska's pass defense, 126th. Out of 128 nationally. And they're thin back there as well. Jonathan Rose suspended. Cockrell out. Give to Jones, a flag on the play as Jones gets out of bounds at the 31.
Holding. Offense, number 75. Penalized half the distance of the goal line. Repeat, first down.
That's David Hedlund, the Swede, originally from Stockholm.
The clock will start on the snap.
He doesn't have to go far for a Thor outfit later tonight.
And he's got the hair to match. That's awesome.
After the penalty, ball spotted at 10. First down.
When you have those types of penalties as a player, it's hard to try to block them out of your mind, especially during these types of circumstances in a ball game.
Markel Jones again looking for the edge, slowed by one defender before he's tackled by Daniel Davey. We do have another flag. This might be a face mask on Desiris.
Personal foul. Face mask. Defense number 23. 15-yard penalty. Automatic. First down.
It's on Davey. First down, Purdue.
Just a poor play there.
Now, that was deserved. They just called it on 23.
Yeah, and as a tackler
ready for play.
And as a defender, you want to make sure you don't get those hands too high because that tends to happen. If you keep them in the proper place, you don't see those types of plays.
Clock running. We come up on 40 seconds to play. Both teams with a pair of timeouts. Wow, pumps using the middle of the field. That's hauled in by Anthrop. Clock continues to run. Purdue has a couple of timeouts. This is caught by Yancey. And he is swallowed up at the 43. That'll momentarily stop the clock. It's a first down, and Purdue's going to call a timeout.
Second charge, timeout of the half. Purdue.
Today's good hands play brought to you by Allstate, and we're going to give it to Anthony Brown.
Yeah, DB getting some love here. First interception of the day for Purdue. He lays out and gets it. And then this next one, top 10 sports center play? I think so. Nice job of breaking the ball off. Keeping concentration and managing to haul that in on the sideline while keeping his feet in. That was a special play and a highlight that he'll remember for the rest of his life.
Speaking of special, the kicking game has been a struggle for Purdue. And Darrell Hazel told us going into the game, from midfield to about the 22-yard line could very well be four down territory. Paul Griggs, the kicker, was great for Purdue last year. He's just 3 of 8 this year. He hasn't attempted a field goal in more than a month. Hasn't made one since week 3. Could be a little trickeration? No. Dan Monteroso with a gain of 2. 12 seconds to go. Monteroso was on the receiving end of a Hail Mary back in week 2 to end the half against Indiana State.
And that time they were looking for Yancey downfield, but Daniel Davey, the cornerback from Beatrice, Nebraska, was all over it.
Nebraska. And that is going to be incomplete. 6 seconds to go, dropped by the tight end Herdman. Purdue still has a timeout. Can you get a play to the sideline here to make the Hail Mary a little more manageable, or do you just go for the end zone now?
I'll tell you what, I may even run the ball here just to get us into halftime. This is a Purdue team that needs to take a lead into the half so they can know what it's like to be able to play out in front. So I wouldn't be shocked here if they run the football and either force Nebraska to call a timeout.
No throw. Wow, downfield for Yancey. in a double coverage. It's tipped and incomplete, and that's how the half will end. Purdue, one half away from its first Big Ten home win under Darryl Hazel. The Boilermakers with a 21-9 lead on Nebraska. Time for the halftime report and Brendan Fitzgerald.
Welcome back to the All-State Saturday Kickoff.
Our halftime score may surprise you. Purdue looking for just its second Big Ten win under Darryl Hazel. The Boilermakers with a 21-9 lead on Nebraska. Anish Shroff, Ahmad Brooks for Purdue. They played well in all three phases in that first half.
Yeah, they have. And I think when you look at this team, it's clear to see that Nebraska has struggled and they've turned over the football. And the difference has been those turnovers, 14 points for Purdue off of turnovers. And I think that is where Nebraska has shot them on their own selves. And that is where Purdue has completely taken advantage.
You can tell Nebraska misses Tommy Armstrong. The Huskers without their starting quarterback today, and Riker Fife has struggled. David Blau has thrown for a touchdown. He's also run for a 56-yard score for the Purdue offense. Anthony Brown has been big. Two interceptions. Purdue's defense, 14 points off three Nebraska turnovers. And Riker Fife, at times, has looked like a kid making his first career start on the road.
I agree, and though he looked good early on in the ball game, those two interceptions were costly for his team, and I'm sure that was the message coming from his offensive coordinator at half.
Nebraska will start at its own 25-yard line. We've seen big plays from Purdue in the first 30 minutes.
Yeah, here you see it. That's just a big-time run here from Blau, the quarterback. Great blocking on that particular play, and then it just started to unravel for Nebraska. As you see there, Jalen Robinson doing a nice job. Defense turns it into points, and they've been doing it on special teams as well. A big block, extra point there, but then the defense coming up big. Two interceptions and none other. This one right here by Anthony Brown was just fantastic. I look to see that one on SportsCenter Top 10.
Riker Fife to throw on first down. He's got Westerkamp. Fourth catch for the junior, and it'll bring up second down and five. Fife making his first career start, came into the game having thrown only 18 career passes. Nebraska's starting quarterback Tommy Armstrong out with an ankle injury. Mike Riley told me before the game, Armstrong day-to-day, he'll be reevaluated Monday. Out of the eye, here's Imani Cross. He gets a couple of more. It'll bring up third down. Rajon Howard on the stop. And here's what you miss with Tommy Armstrong. The completion percentage, maybe not where you want it to be, but a strong arm and his ability to improvise. That's where Riker Fife at times has made mistakes.
I agree, and one of the things you don't see on here is his leadership skills. He's the unquestioned leader on this Nebraska football team, and when you lose a leader like that, it is going to affect your team.
Fife on third down. He wants Westerkamp, who makes the catch right at the marker. And that'll move the chains. Clark on the stop. A first down, Nebraska.
Yeah, Westerkamp and Leroy Clark have been going at it and battling all game long. That time, Westerkamp getting better of Clark. But Clark today has made some plays, and I can assure you this. Nebraska will look for Westerkamp. Wherever he's at, the football is soon to come.
Again to the air. Fife in trouble. Throws off his back foot too high for Divine Ozigbo. Pressure coming that time from Evan Panfil.
Yeah, and that wasn't the ideal throw for sure, but give him credit. I mean, he's either going to take a sack there or he tried to find a late target that popped open for him, though. But the pressure, doing a nice job. And that time, Evan Panfil doing a wonderful job of keeping contained, falling back underneath, but not allowing the quarterback to get outside. That's good defense there from Purdue.
Play action. Fife over the middle. Hubby wide open. He's to midfield. And finally swarmed at the 48 of Purdue. It's another Nebraska first down, a gain of 17.
And that was great play action. They suck in the linebackers. You see the linebackers there, everybody coming up, which just opens up the middle of the field for Fife to be able to just a nice pitch and catch there from this Nebraska offense.
Ozigbo back in at running back. You wonder what's happened to Terrell Newby. 10 carries, 56 yards, but he wasn't in late in the second half. We have not seen him to start the third quarter as Ozigbo with a little bit of room down the sideline, finally chased down by Danny Ezechukwu. It's a gain of 30.
Yeah, and he's not new to this backfield. He just hadn't seen a lot of action. He averaged over 10 yards a carry versus Illinois. This time here, getting him involved in the passing game and just finding a crease. And the young man has probably been sitting on the sideline just waiting for his opportunity. That time there, showing the coaches that he wants more reps.
Two catches for Ozigbo today. He had one all season entering the game. Fife for the end zone, incomplete. And there is a flag back at the 30.
Personal foul, roughing the passer, defense number 54. Penalized half the distance to the goal line, automatic, first down.
Yeah, Jake Fogle just doing a little bit extra on this particular play. He just completely annihilates the left guard, gets into the face of the quarterback. It's that final push right there that the officials called. That was the roughing the passer. And that was a monstrous play to be able to beat the left guard, get to the quarterback. You just would like to see him make a wiser decision and not make that play.
First and goal from the 9 after the penalty. Off play action. High throw intended for Morgan, who already has a touchdown grab today.
That's the third play action pass we've seen from this Nebraska offense coming back out after half. It seems as though maybe that's something that they're going to go to. Pearson Hill out of the game with an injury. That's their guy that likes to go horizontal. And so now they're saying, let's try to get these linebackers to commit to the run game and open up some passing lanes right in behind them.
Pearson Hill carted off the field in the first half. High snap. Cross into the end zone for a TD. That is the 24th career rushing touchdown for Amani Cross and the 5th against Purdue. Cross had a couple of TDs against the Boilermakers last year and two more in 2013.
Did it with big runs from their running backs. Ozigbo here, the nice catch and run after the catch. And then they finish it off with the big power back to punch it right in the end zone on Purdue and to decrease that lead.
A touchdown run by Amani Cross, his second rushing TD of the season, 24th of his career, and Nebraska has closed to within 21-16. Huskers scored on their opening drives of both halves. Danny Anthrop maneuvers his way to the 20. Well, Nebraska's been in close games all season, and it hasn't ended well. Week 1, BYU wins on Tanner Mangum's Hail Mary. Then against Miami, the Huskers rallied from 23 down to force overtime, only to lose in OT. Illinois came back from 13 down in the fourth quarter. The Illini scored the winning touchdown with 10 seconds left. Against Wisconsin, the Badgers won on a 46-yard field goal with 4 seconds left. And last week, Northwestern won 30-28. Nebraska had a chance to tie, but a two-point conversion attempt was no good with about 4.5 minutes to go, and the Wildcats ran out the clock. And that is incredible. Not only four losses in the final 10 seconds, but four losses on the opponent's final offensive play. Second and 10 here for Purdue. Blau rolling to his right, underneath. He's got Anthrop. Got away from Kalu and then tackled from the backside by Williams. And we've got a flag. Don Willard in the white hat, our head referee.
There is no foul in the play for the block in the back. The block in the back is legal. Block in question is legal.
So a third down coming up for Purdue. They've got to get to the 30. Receivers stacked to each side. Quarterback draw. And Blau looks to have enough for a first down.
That's the second big play that I've seen out of that design quarterback draw. We talked about it earlier in the first half. Offensive coordinator John Shoup, along with head coach Daryl Hazel, said, we want to go more to that play and really try to highlight the athleticism of Blau. I think they've done a good job today of mixing it in with what he does well.
There's Markell Jones, and he's tackled by Malik Collins after a gain of two. Collins, the 300-pound junior out of Kansas City, he's a captain. He's been one of the few guys who's been healthy all season on this defense, and they've needed him.
Yeah, he just eats up blocks, and he's so athletic for his size, and certainly a player that Nebraska relies on to help stop the run.
That pass caught by Posey. And Cameron Posey with a first down to the 44, brought down by Gangwish. Blau fakes the pass, finds Jones. And a freshman run out of bounds by Marcus Newby after a gain of nine. It'll be interesting to see how Markell Jones holds up. He's used to splitting carries with DJ Knox, but Knox is out with an ankle injury today. And Jones has been on the field a lot.
He has, but when you're a playmaker, you want as many touches as you can get.
They'll feed to Jones again. And he picks up a first down, brought down by Didrick Young. Markell Jones today, 8 carries. 9 now after that last one. He also has 4 catches. This was a kid who ran for 157 yards on 22 carries against Michigan State earlier this season. And as a true freshman, he's the only player this season to run for more than 100 against the Spartans.
That's impressive.
Wow, fakes it to Anthrop. Another check down to Jones. He's got a little bit of room. And Jones inside the 25. Finally brought down by Collins. A gain of 18. There's another explosive play by Purdue.
Yeah, and they went back to the same play that they went to a few plays previous. And this time, they're just trying to get the Nebraska defense to go one way. So he pump fakes it one direction, gets outside. They sneak the running back outside, Markell Jones. And that was a good timing for Blau to turn around and make that throw. That's a play he looks comfortable running.
Blau again, moving the pocket. And that's caught by Anthrop. And a nice tackle in space by Kalu. What's interesting about it, both defensive coordinator Mike Banker for Nebraska and offensive coordinator John Shoup told us, hey, they thought this game would be won in the A-gaps. That means it's a line of scrimmage, smash mouth game. When Purdue's had the ball, it's been a lot of misdirection, and they've tried to go to the perimeter a lot more than we thought today.
And it looks like it's working for them.
They do it again there. Blau moving the pocket. Little dump pass. And the flare is caught by Herdman.
That was a pretty sweet play. You see it here. It doesn't look like there's anything opening up for them as they come with the play action. And the tight end doing a nice job of releasing there. You would have liked for the Nebraska defenders, one to rush the quarterback, one to stay back in coverage. Blau makes them pay because they made an ill-advised decision.
John Shoup told us they had to get Blau in a rhythm. He's in a rhythm right now.
Yeah, and it's been all short and intermediate throws. You haven't seen him take a shot in the second half.
He'll take a shot here. He wants Yancey, and that's broken up by Daniel Davey.
Just great timing. And this is hard to do. To be able to be conscious of when the ball's coming. Jumps, great timing, great concentration, getting the proper hand out there while also being able to secure the tackle on the backside. That was a good play there from the young man from Nebraska.
This Nebraska pass defense has been much maligned, but they're pretty good at punching the ball out. Wow, again, another flare pass. And that's caught by Anthrop. He's to the five, third and goal. Do you rule out a designed quarterback run here, Ahmad?
No, I don't. It's worked for him, and this would be another timely call if they want to put the ball in Blau's hands.
Anthrop in the slot. Blau. End zone. Caught by Jurasevich.
Wow.
Seldom used tight end Jordan Jurasevich in the passing game, at least, with his fourth catch of the season and first touchdown as a Boilermaker.
And how about the Boilermakers coming back and answering the call after Nebraska just marched up and down the field to punch one in? Purdue comes back. You see Blau gets into a rhythm and caps that off with a fine touch pass into the end zone.
David Blau, calm under pressure, and Jurasevich hauls it in for the score. 28-16 Purdue, that mass.
Benjamin Button, how about that?
Happy Halloween. Nebraska has lived a spook story pretty much all season, and if Husker fans are looking at the scoreboard, this one's a little hard to believe, but it's happening. Purdue with a 12-point lead here in West Lafayette. And Morgan dumped as he crosses the 20 by Leroy Clark. Jordan Jurasevich with just his fourth catch of the season and by far the biggest one of the year for Purdue.
Yeah, and this is a difficult catch to make as you see that SportsCenter top 10 over the shoulder to be able to haul it in with the defensive back Aaron Williams draped all over him as we take another look at it. And this Nebraska defense, they have not allowed a third quarter touchdown the last four games. So for Purdue to come out here, establish themselves after the half, that was an important drive.
Monty Cross, the big 240-pound senior out of Gainesville, Georgia, with a gain of five. We have an update on Terrell Newby, Nebraska's leading rusher. He's in street clothes now. He left the game with a left leg injury. So you think about what's missing on offense for the Huskers. Your top running back, your top quarterback, and one of your most dangerous playmakers, DeMornay Pearson-L, who was carted off in the first half. Fife slings one to Westerkamp to the 40. A first down for Nebraska, a gain of 13.
And that's been an option that they've gone to all game long. Slants across the middle of the field. Westerkamp one of the more capable wide receivers in the country of recognizing space, knowing where to go, getting in the right windows. And he has really done a fine job for Nebraska today in doing that.
Six catches for Jordan Westerkamp. Fife floats one over the head of Westerkamp, covered by the safety Clark. And second and 10 with Ahmad Brooks and Ishraf. It's the All-State Saturday kickoff. Purdue looking to snap a five-game losing streak. The Boilermakers leading 28-16. Purdue 14 points off of three Nebraska turnovers.
You know, and Darryl Hazel told us that this Purdue team was close. And from the looks of it today, they've come out here, played with good energy. They've made plays. They've created turnovers. This has been one of their better performances all year long.
Ozigbo drops it. And again, that's where you miss Newby, who was such a big part of the passing game.
Yeah, and until his credit, too, he hasn't gotten a lot of game reps. And despite the fact that when the ball hits you in the hands, you've got to catch it. But he's a young player trying to gain confidence. As they tried to go to him there on a swing pass, he just wasn't able to haul it in.
When we asked Mike Riley to describe this season, he used the word haunting. One close call after another, and every break has gone against Nebraska seemingly all season. On third and 10, Fife, Westerkamp can't bring it in with one hand. Garcia on the coverage. And credit this Purdue defense. You know, Nebraska's been snake bitten, but they're going to get zero sympathy from Purdue. Purdue's had its share of close calls as well that haven't gone its way.
You're right. And for Darryl Hazel and this coaching staff, they're starting to get contributions from their juniors, the sophomores that they've recruited. And guys are starting to make plays, and that can be the difference in a season, clearly. And so for them to come back and to really shut this offense down on their second possession, that's something that can give you confidence and let you know, hey, we can really pull this off and close this game.
Fair catch signal by Frankie Williams at the 16. The All-Star Classic, Nebraska. If the Huskers lose this game, he'd be 3-6. And given the history of coaches at Nebraska, they don't necessarily get a long leash, even ones who've had success.
And you're referring to Frank Solich.
Bo Pelini.
And I couldn't agree with you more, but I think this fan base has seen enough promise, and this team has been competitive. They just haven't closed out games.
Jones wrestled to the ground. Tackle made by Valentine after a gain of a yard. Mike Riley, who's one of the good guys in the sport, that's been his reputation, and you meet him, you talk to him, that comes across right away. You know, we asked him, what sort of leeway do you expect from the fan base? And he was pretty honest about it. He goes, listen, we've had some tough breaks, and you can stay up all night what-ifing this and what-ifing that. But he goes, the fans in Nebraska, rightfully so, expect wins. And he's tried to make this about football. What went wrong from a football standpoint? Forget the luck. Forget all the other things. Blau downfield for Yancey. Makes the catch. Yancey breaks free. Down the sideline. Touchdown, Purdue.
Wow. That might have been the best throw Blau has had all day today. He did it on the move and put the ball on the money.
An 83-yard strike to D'Angelo Yancey, who had just one catch in his last two games.
Let's have one more look at this touchdown. Yancey, they missed this opportunity in the first half. They come back. Daniel Davey gets beat on coverage. Yancey does the rest. And this Purdue team has some confidence and the lead.
Nebraska fans who made the trip to West Lafayette, a little forlorn. Purdue rolling 35-16. This Purdue coaching staff talked about big plays, and they've had them from offense, defense, and special teams. David Blau set the tone with a 56-yard touchdown run, and then he threw a TD pass on the last drive, 83 yards to D'Angelo Yancey. Brandon Riley will run this out, tackled shy of the 20. It's a proud history in Lincoln. Bob Devaney got things going when he got there in 1962. The Huskers have only had two losing seasons since 62. Tom Osborne won three national titles. He gave way to Frank Solich, who averaged better than 9.5 wins in his tenure. Then the dark days under Bill Callahan. Two losing seasons under Callahan, who lasted just 4 years. Bo Pelini never went worse than 9-4. And Mike Riley, in many circles, was really a surprise out of left field hire when that's who Nebraska pegged in the offseason.
Yeah, there were some people definitely wondering, was that the best that Nebraska could do, with all due respect to Mike Riley.
Mike's pass intercepted. The third pick of the game by Anthony Brown.
Oh, wow. When it's your day, it's your day. And he's created two turnovers. That time, no fight. Just threw it to him. As you'll see here, it looked like the wide receiver came inside. Fife throws it outside. To the right of your screen is where he'll be throwing the football. Westerkamp ran an in route, yet he threw the ball outside. But a fine job there from Anthony Brown, getting his hands on the wide receiver, disrupting the route, and then finishing the catch for his third interception of the ball game.
And Purdue's got a chance to throw a haymaker here, up 35-16, ball in plus territory. And the Boilermakers start in the red zone. Little pop pass. Anthrop zigzags his way to the 15-yard line for a gain of four. Purdue has been in the red zone 8 times in conference play. It's resulted in 8 touchdowns.
That's a great number there. Good production. Brown, 3 interceptions on the day. That's just one of those.
Career day for him.
Indeed.
Again, a little trickeration. That's Gregory Phillips. We're seeing a ton of misdirection, a ton of plays to the perimeter. Blau moving the pocket. This Nebraska defense has been confused by it.
Well, I don't think this Purdue team was scared of the middle, but when you've got two players that are dominant in the middle, it just makes sense to spread this defense out, pepper them with plays on the outside, run the jet sweep, make this defense honest. And Purdue has been able to do that, and they've been able to do it with good rhythm and good pace.
Now, this is the progress Darryl Hazel has been trying to sell. Fans have got to see some tangible results. They've seen it through the better part of 3 quarters. Blau underneath. Nice tackle that time by Nate Gary as Jurasovich made the catch.
Fourth down situation here. What will Hazel do?
Do you go for it or do you bring out the kicker?
He looks like he's going for it. Their offense is on the field. This is a big call here for Hazel. As they're changing personnel, but it looks like this offense is set to go for it here on fourth down inside of the red zone.
Purdue has attempted 23 fourth down tries, most in the nation. They've converted 12. Play clock at 4. And now Purdue will call a timeout. First time out of the half for Darryl Hazel's squad. You know, we talked about Nebraska's close losses. Purdue has had its fair share in the season opener against Marshall. Austin Appleby, who was the starting quarterback then, threw 2 pick sixes. The one in the closing minutes sealed the game for the Thundering Herd. Then against Bowling Green, The Falcons scored the game-winning touchdown with 9 seconds left in regulation. Bowling Green won 35-28. Against Michigan State, Purdue rallied from 21-0 down. They had the ball down three, but the Spartans forced a turnover on downs near midfield late in the fourth quarter as Michigan State hung on.
And that's why Darrell Hazel said that this team believes they're close. They've seen how they were able to compete with teams like Michigan State, and now you see what they're made of here on this fourth down.
Blau's going to run it, and he's got the first down.
Yeah, Hazel here really rolled the dice here, and his quarterback just made a play for him.
What's the message
there? As it looked like he was supposed to go in the middle of the field, Blau having the smarts and the wisdom to say, you know what, it's clogged up in the middle, and I've got Big Collins and Valentine here. Let me take it to the left, and it was just enough for the first down.
What's the message going forward in that situation up 19?
Well, it tells us we're here to win, and we are trying our best to make sure that we send Nebraska out of here today with a loss.
This is for Yancey. Touchdown, Purdue. Yancey, second of the game.
They have found a favorable matchup, and that is the one of number 23, Daniel Davey, the cornerback for Nebraska, and D'Angelo Yancey, the young man from Atlanta, Georgia, the junior. He's got great length. You saw him with his breakaway speed earlier to run away from defenders. That time there showing that he can be a playmaker in the red zone. Teams look for guys like that that can take advantage of one-on-one opportunities, make a catch, and score points for your team.
Four catches, 100 yards, two TDs for the junior from Atlanta.
And this is just a beautifully thrown ball. Wow. And Hazel on the sideline. Excitement. And I understand why. Relief.
Ahmad, you and I were here in week three when Purdue played Virginia Tech. And before that game, Darrell Hazel was all sorts of confident about his team's ability to win that game. He thought his team was close. He thought that had a chance to be a program-changing win. Instead, Virginia Tech won 51-24, and it felt Purdue had invested so much emotion leading up to that game. Well, that was the start of a five-game losing streak. When we met with Darrell Hazel yesterday, it was a little more of a somber approach, but that confidence was still there. Despite it all, he had faith in where this team could end up. As Riley takes it out to the 30 for Nebraska, he kept on telling us, hey, we're close, it's going to happen. And, you know, if you've watched this team through the course of 6-7 games, it's easy to have your doubts, and especially the last two games.
You know what helps? It's having a quarterback. And David Blau today has been outstanding. 25 of 36, 254 yards, 4 touchdowns, and he's protected the ball with no interceptions. And they said, look, we believe that this kid can be really good. Darrell Hazel told us that in the meetings yesterday, and we've probably seen him have his breakout performance here today.
Amani Cross moves the pile to the 37. Second and three, and we have an update from Brendan. Ole Miss holds a lot of cards in the SEC. First college football playoff rankings will come out on Tuesday.
Excited about it.
Downfield from Fife, incomplete. He wanted Westerkamp. Darrell Hazel told us yesterday it was imperative not just to get a win, but to get it at Ross-Ade Stadium. These fans in Hazel's 2+ seasons have not seen a home conference win.
We talked about selling progress, and to do it here in West Lafayette, to have an opportunity, and this game isn't over, but you look at what Purdue's been able to do on defense. They've got four turnovers, 21 points off of those turnovers, and so far it has been an outstanding performance from the Boilermakers.
Fife has an open Westerkamp. Fights off one defender, Clark, before being tackled by Brown. A gain of 11. A first down for the Huskers. On the flip side, Ahmad, you grew up in Texas. You came to the University of Texas when Nebraska was still Nebraska. They brought in Mike Riley. The hope in Lincoln was that this program can get back to the heights that it used to be at.
Yeah, I just remember all of the greats, the Winstrom boys, Lawrence Phillips, Tommy Frazier. And Nebraska right now is trying to tap into that. And if you're a player, now's the time where you can really show how great you are by living in that legacy and creating your own.
Cross bulldozes ahead to the 42. There is a flag.
Personal foul, hands to the face, defense number 18. 15-yard penalty will be added to the end of the run. Automatic first down.
You and I were both under 40. We were talking about that 95 team over lunch yesterday.
Wow.
Best team I can remember in my lifetime with Tommy Frazier and Lawrence Phillips. They steamrolled everybody.
Yeah.
But given how the landscape of college football has changed, and I don't think Nebraska's brand has diminished so much as other brands
I would agree.
Have now maybe begun to rival it some more or have emerged, and it makes it tougher to get the best players, not as easy as it used to be. Cable TV has changed the game a little for Nebraska. Fife underneath. And that's crossed to the 20-yard line. And now a late flag.
Yeah, and you're so right, Anish. When you talk about recruiting, though, the thing that boosts recruiting the most is winning football games, and especially winning big football games. And for Nebraska, that's been a spot where they've struggled. So to your point of the recruiting, when you see a team win on the big stage, you want to be a part of it. You want to go there. And so not to say that they haven't done enough on the recruiting trail, but they are up against a lot right now.
There's no foul on the play.
Not winning the big games.
The question was legal. It was on the side.
Not winning the big games. That's what ultimately did in Bo Pelini. And you look at this tradition. Five national championships. Mid to late 90s, this was the standard in college football. Three Heisman Trophy winners. Only two losing seasons since 1962. Both of those under Bill Callahan. And those were the only two seasons since 69 when Nebraska did not go bowling. Fife heaves that one up. Incomplete, broken up by Frankie Williams. And sometimes Riker Fife, it just seems he's throwing it up there and praying.
You're right, but this is a difficult situation for an inexperienced quarterback to be in. You're down by this many points. You've got to go to the air to try to keep yourself in the ball game. And this Purdue defense is pinning their ears back, and they are getting after it with tight man coverage on the back end. And that is the formula to shut teams down and to close out ball games.
Third and two. Crossing route. Morgan makes the catch, and he's got a first down. And that should be the final play of this third quarter. Purdue comes out of halftime with three third quarter touchdowns. Darryl Hazel 15 minutes away from his first home Big Ten victory. Who's in the top four? The first college football playoff rankings come out. You can watch them unveiled on ESPN. Start of the fourth quarter here at Ross 8. It's been all Purdue. Riker Fife across the middle. Touchdown Nebraska to start the fourth quarter. Lane Hovey. And I guess if we know anything about Nebraska, there's still a chance this could turn into a game.
That was just a dart there by Fife. He put it in the right window and just kind of threw the wide receiver open and into the end zone. That was the throw that he's probably been looking for all game long.
Point after by Brown is good, and a late flag. Lane Hovey on the receiving end of that last touchdown as we listen to Don Willard.
Running into the kicker. Defense, that penalty's declined. Try is good. Timeout.
The score. Today's game track is brought to you by Taco Bell. Purdue has done it with some big plays, but the key stat there, Ahmad, has been turnovers. Four turnovers leading to 21 Purdue points, and that's been the difference in this game.
Yeah, I mean, it's clear to see. I mean, there's not a lot of difference in terms of total yards. It's not a lot of difference in terms of pass yards nor rush yards. And so when you look at this game, the one thing that you'll go back to and say, where was the key for Purdue to get started and to get the momentum and to gain the confidence to win the ball game? It was clearly, I believe, on the sack fumble that led to a touchdown. And that really gave this Purdue defense the momentum and the confidence they needed to do it again and again and again.
Still plenty of time left. Nebraska down 19. We'll kick this one deep. Frankie Williams breaks the tackle, has the 20, and dropped at the 27. Game day in the city of brotherly love this morning. Philadelphia on ABC. Boy, the American Conference, Temple, Memphis, Houston, all undefeated, all with impressive wins against Power 5 teams. Memphis has beaten Ole Miss. Houston beat Louisville. Temple already with a win against Penn State out of the Big Ten.
And boy, would they be well represented if they can knock off Notre Dame. But that conference certainly has made some damage in terms of their reputation throughout the country.
Blau chased by DeZuris, and he'll throw it away. Meanwhile, Purdue looking for just its second win of the season. First against an FBS school, the other against Indiana State. Darryl Hazel's only won two games against FBS competition. And only one Power 5 win in two-plus seasons. That's dropped by Yancey. It's been a bugaboo with him throughout his Purdue career.
You know, my question is here, if you're this Purdue offense, why is it your first two times out you've gone through the air? Try to run the football, milk some of this clock, and protect this lead. I understand trying to take shots and score more points, but right now, I just think you need to run the football.
Back to the air, back to Yancey, and he hangs on for a first down.
Now, this is just a great ball, thrown in the right location, wonderful timing. And look at how Yancey was able to get his body in the proper position to make that play. And once again, that happens on the defensive right side of the field with that matchup, Daniel Davey along with D'Angelo Yancey.
Nebraska's secondary has been a weakness this season. They're thin this afternoon. Danny Anthrop gets away from DeZuris and forced out of bounds by Valentine, who goes crashing into the Nebraska sideline.
Yeah, and they said they were going to move him around and that he may potentially get some touches out of the backfield today with Knox being out of the ball game. And that time there, just trying to make something happen, you would have liked to have seen him be able to get a little more yardage and potentially get back to the line of scrimmage, but wasn't able to do it, but the clock still runs.
Second and 12. Anthrop in motion. Markell Jones takes the tackler to the 41, a gain of four. Third down now for Purdue. Now they've got Daniel Davey on Anthony Mahungu, the Purdue sophomore who's from Paris, France. That's the matchup that you'll see in a moment at the top of your screen. On third and eight, and Bilal Marshall cannot hold on. The junior from Miami drops it, and it's fourth down. Tough catch to begin with. And Purdue will have to punt, so hang on a second. If you're Nebraska, you already rallied from 23 down in the fourth quarter against Miami to force overtime. There's still plenty of time left. The Huskers have all three timeouts. Not so fast, as our friend Lee Corso would say.
Indeed. And I think this is an important drive here for Nebraska, because if you can continue to score points, move the ball, that really helps. And for Purdue, you know, they only ran off a minute and 42 seconds off the clock that last drive. If you're this Purdue offense, you need to do more than that.
Big series coming up for Riker, Fife, and in Nebraska. We're back after this. Darryl Hazel hoping for his first Big Ten home win and just second Big Ten win overall in 19 tries. Meanwhile, Nebraska hoping to extend this game. They're down by 19. Riker Fife making his first career start at quarterback in place of the injured Tommy Armstrong. And Fife's pass a little too high for Seathan Carter, the tight end. Fife came into this game having attempted just 18 career passes, 36 pass attempts this afternoon. Off play action, that's to Westerkamp. Sheds one tackler, and then finally gang tackled at the 46. 17 yards on the play, it's a Nebraska first down.
Just taking advantage of one-on-one opportunities as Leroy Clark and Jordan Westerkamp continue to go at it on that in that slot. And it looks like Purdue has chosen to go to a man-free zone where they are playing man-to-man, and they've got one deep safety to try to prevent Nebraska from getting the big play over the top.
Fife downfield. Riley able to hang on. And Riley tripped up inside the five. They'll mark him down at the 2-yard line. There is a penalty marker.
I think he did this despite pass interference.
Prior to the pass being thrown, holding defense number 9. That penalty is declined. First down, Nebraska.
What are they saying, basketball? And one.
No question. That's exactly what that was right there. Wow, those are the types of plays that now get your confidence going. And we go back to when Purdue has the football, you've got to be able to milk the clock, because now you've really allowed Nebraska to know that they can get back in this ball game, especially if they're going downfield and making plays like that.
52-yard catch by Riley, his longest of the season. Goal line set, cross the deep back. Janovich, the fullback. They'll give it to the fullback, Janovich. Muscling ahead. And he's going to be marked just shy of the goal line. Second and goal.
Yeah, and Janovich is not your traditional and typical fullback. They like to get him involved in the passing game, though we haven't seen him today. But they will hand him the football, and they trust him. Speaking to offense coordinator Danny Langsford, he said, "We trust him as much as our running backs to carry the football."
Back to Janovich, and he's ahead and through for a TD.
It's a replay. Let's see if he gets in. Looks like that second effort after contact is what got him in there. He just keeps churning those legs, pushing. It looks like from this angle that was a touchdown.
Nebraska will go for two. Remember, they missed an extra point earlier. It was blocked. Ozigbo, the running back. Fife moves the pocket. Throwing for the end zone. It's caught by Westerkamp. Nebraska with a couple of quick fourth quarter scores. It's a ball game in West Lafayette. Dressed up for Halloween. Mike Riley's team has had a lead in the fourth quarter in every game this season. They've led or they've been tied, I should say, except for this one. And Nebraska went into this fourth quarter down by 26. They've trimmed 15 points off that deficit in less than 4 minutes.
They scored on the first play coming into this quarter, and then they just marched up and down the field. They get a big play, and next thing you know, they punch it in. And if you are Purdue, I go back to that last possession where you had an opportunity to try to run out the clock. Now you're wondering, do we continue to try to score points, add to our lead? Because now they're within a deficit that they can certainly come back and win this ball game.
Toss to Jones. Gets a block. Jones across the 30. And a nice run on first down, a gain of 7. Ahmad Purdue has not been in these situations many times. Closing out a game. Does doubt creep in?
It does. You know, it's hard when you have habits and you have shown that this is who we are, this is what we've done, and all of a sudden now you're trying to protect the lead. So as much of it is as this coaching staff, yes, these players, they've got to make sure that their mental focus is sharp and that they fight off the noise in their head saying, hey, we've never done this before, and they've got to go out here and just close.
Anthrop, screen. He's got a first down to move the chains. Ninth catch of the game for Danny Anthrop. Anthrop, a senior captain, tore his ACL against Nebraska last year. He grew up just 5 minutes from campus on a 90-acre farm. He's the mayor in West Lafayette. Jones looking for room. There's not much there. And we check in with Brendan Fitzgerald.
Anish, after Chad Kelly's second interception of the ball game, Jeremy Johnson, remember him? Look at this trick play for Auburn. Big gainer here to Tony Stevens. Auburn would have to settle for a field goal. It is a one-point game at Jordan-Hare Stadium in Auburn.
All right, thank you, Brendan. Here it's an 11-point game, but it was a 26-point Purdue lead just a few minutes ago when this fourth quarter began. On the ground, Jones got a yard and a half, third down coming up. So this drive, Ahmad, Darrell Hazel has been more conservative. A screen pass, mostly runs.
I think that's the way to go. And not only what you do here is you put the game in the hands of your offensive line. And from what we've heard from this staff is that they really like how this offensive line has improved. And this is where you really see what this offensive line is made of, because you're running the football, Nebraska knows you're running the football, and can you still do it?
And they're also bleeding the play clock on this drive. Blau's going to run. He's got a first down and more as he slides down near the 45.
Now that wasn't a design run, that was just a boot where he sees space and he does the right thing. He takes off running, was aware of where the sticks were, he slides. He did everything right on that play, Blau did, and I think that's indicative of what this young man has done today. He's really grown up, he's made some plays, and he's put his team on his back.
Now you said it, he's grown up today, 27 out of 41, 271 yards, 4 touchdowns. His
good
best
numbers.
Game is a Boilermaker.
Absolutely.
Jones breaks the tackle. Stiff arm, and he's out of bounds at the 40.
Yeah, if you're Jones, you've got to get down. You cannot run out of bounds here. Keep trying to run off that clock. I know he was trying to fight for extra yardage, but that's where you have to understand situational football and what's going on and what your team's trying to accomplish. And I could see here from the sideline, the coaches were giving him a signal, get down.
Clock running now, less than 8 minutes to go here in regulation. Purdue nursing an 11-point lead. And again, letting the play clock run down. Quarterback draw. Blau met by Josh Banderas. Third down. Banderas, another guy in that Nebraska defense who's missed time with injuries. He had a groin issue early in the season. The Huskers' secondary has struggled today, but again, they're without Jonathan Rose, who's suspended. Their leading tackler, a safety, Byerson Cockrell, not with the team. He's attending a family funeral. Big third and four. Blau will throw it. Anthrop able to make the catch, but he's going to be marked, it appears, just short of the first down marker. And now what does Darryl Hazel do?
Yeah, it looks like he's going to run this down and perhaps call a timeout. And I think that's the smart thing to do. Make sure you can eat up as much of this clock as possible. It looks like the offense is migrating off. And I know that, you know, this is an opportunity for them to try to make the field long for Nebraska. If you can get a good punt here, if you decide to come on, get a clean punt off, get it inside of the 10, make them march the length of the field, that is how you will continue to milk this clock.
Hazel does just what you forecasted. Timeout Purdue, fourth and one when we come back. Fourth and one, Purdue. Ball at the Nebraska 37. The Boilermakers have gone for it for an FBS high 24 times on fourth down. And the offense comes out on the field. What do you make of the call?
Make it 25. I mean, if they can convert here, boy, did they put Nebraska in a real pickle. So I think what Darryl Hazel is doing right now, he's going for the win.
Under center. Blau. Little bootleg. He's going to throw it downfield. Are you kidding me? Incomplete. Intended for Yancey. There is a penalty marker.
Ineligible receiver downfield. Offense, number 72. That penalty is declined. Result of the play is an incomplete pass. Turnover on downs. First down, Nebraska.
Ahmad, what did you make of that play call?
I thought what most Purdue fans were thinking, oh no, that this happened. And, you know, Blau, he's wide open. He's got an opportunity to go downfield. Yancey's wide open. He just couldn't put it in the right location. And I think that's why you don't put the ball in that particular situation in the hands of your quarterback to throw a ball downfield. Was it open? Yes. Was it the wisest decision? In my humble opinion, no.
Well, if Purdue ends up losing this game, Darryl Hazel is going to face some questions in the post-game press conference and during the week. Meanwhile, the door is opened up for Nebraska. Fife, that throw tipped, juggled, picked off. Purdue gets it back. Frankie Williams inside the 25, still on his feet. And down to the 7-yard line.
Wow, they finally got a break, Purdue did. And boy, was this another play that could be up for the top 10. The third one of the day. Watch how this thing just careens all over the place. One touch, two touch, three touch, four touch. Finally get it, Frankie Williams. It falls in his hands. And how about the run after the catch? And can we just give the player of the game to the entire defense with the way that they've created takeaways? They've, They've been there when their team has needed them, and they have, looks what it looks like, shut the door on this Nebraska team.
Purdue's defense had 6 interceptions all season coming into today. The Boilermakers have 4 in this game.
Wow.
All of them have come by the starting corners, 3 by Anthony Brown, and for Frankie Williams, that was his 9th career pick. When you're feeling lucky, I guess. Here's Jones. Stiff arm. Touchdown, Boilermakers. That makes it a 3-possession game, 5:51 to go in regulation. What a sequence.
And look at this crazy play. But Purdue finally made it happen. It just goes through the wide receiver's hands. Frankie Williams there has a couple opportunities to make the pick. The run after the catch, a nice job there of bobbing and weaving through Nebraska's offense. And then the 4th touchdown off of turnovers today, 28 points, and that's been the difference. The ability for Purdue's defense to get the takeaways and the ability of this offense to score.
Nebraska and Purdue both came into this game in the midst of star-crossed seasons. You thought the ball was going to bounce somebody's way today. Somebody was due for better luck. And every bounce has gone Purdue's way. To the Boilermakers' credit, they've capitalized on the opportunities they've had. And for Nebraska, that bouncing ball, in many ways, that's their season in a nutshell, isn't it?
I would agree. And, you know, that's just an unfortunate situation for Nebraska. You have an opportunity. You've come out and you've really put the pressure on Purdue by coming out and scoring quickly. And then you have a play like that happen after you stop them on a 4th down. That can be deflating.
Squid kick. Fielded by Nelson. And we get a studio update from Brendan Fitzgerald. Brendan?
Anish, coming up next, it's Boise State taking on UNLV. Brett Rippon, whose uncle is Super Bowl champ Mark Rippon. They're not playing on the blue in Boise. They're playing on the felt at Sam Boyd Stadium. Coming up next. Back to you.
Look at that. Nebraska, one turnover in its previous 249 plays entering the game. Today they've turned it over 5 times, and all 5 have been on the quarterback, Riker Fife, making his first career start in place of the injured Tommy Armstrong.
Yeah, you got to think Nebraska fans are sitting here wondering, what if Tommy Armstrong were here and healthy?
Incomplete, 2nd and 10, a late flag. DeJuan Hunt, the nickelback, on the coverage. Mike Riley told us Armstrong was day-to-day all week, even though he didn't practice. They're going to reevaluate him on Monday. He's got a sprained ankle.
Prior to the pass being thrown, holding, defense number 2. Balacorda gets an eligible receiver, 10-yard penalty, and automatic first down.
Well, Tommy Armstrong, who injured his ankle in the Northwestern loss last week, was having a pretty good season for Nebraska, 16 TDs, 7 picks. In many ways, still adjusting to Mike Riley's offense, to new offense this year. But they've missed his ability to improvise and make big plays when things break down. That's a strike to Brandon Riley. 4th catch for Riley. For Nebraska, if the final score holds, they will have to win the remaining 3 games to become bowl eligible. 3-man rush. And Fife slides down at the 36. Now, there might be one loophole that could still get Nebraska into a bowl game if they finish 5-7.
Yeah.
You got 40 bowl games, and if you can't fill the 80 spots, then you start looking at teams who are not bowl eligible, 5-7 teams,
yeah.
And it comes down to APR. And if it did come down to APR, Nebraska would be in pretty good shape, and they'd have a chance to get one of those bowl bids. But again, this is assuming you can't fill all the spots for the 40 bowls.
Yeah. And this Purdue defensive line doing a fine job of applying pressure, but you see that. Only years without a bowl appearance, that is just amazing. 2004 and 2007, this is not a program that's used to not being relevant and not being in the spotlight when it's bowl season. So Mike Riley and his staff are going to have to answer some tough questions this week.
Jamal Turner down to the 25-yard line for a gain of 17. The only coach since 1969 not to go to a bowl game, Bill Callahan. And that is not a guy you want to be associated with in Lincoln. Stephen Carter, a pickup of 7. Now, in Mike Riley's defense, 4 excruciating losses that could have gone either way. Maybe if the wind was blowing in the right direction for Nebraska. They lose on a Hail Mary against Miami. The Huskers erased a 23-point fourth quarter deficit, only to lose an OT. This one floated for Ozigbo. There is a flag. Illinois in a windy, blustery game scored the game winner with 10 seconds to go in regulation. The Wisconsin one has to sting. Looked like Nebraska all but had that. Give the ball back up with about a minute to go, and Wisconsin hits a 46-yard field goal. And then the injuries, that's part of the equation as well, Ahmad.
Yeah, it's been a lot of things. And Mike Riley said that this week. It's been a combination of things. But what I will say is he also took full responsibility. He said, you know, as coaches, we need to coach better. We need to put our players in better position. He said, and we're challenging our players to make sure that they understand that the expectations at a place like Nebraska are high for a reason, and they've got to figure out a way to continue to try to meet those expectations.
Fife on the move, throwing into the end zone, and that is caught by Riley for a touchdown. Still 3.5 minutes to go here in the fourth. With Nebraska in the game, I'm still not ruling out anything.
Yeah, you can't. And the only thing right now, if you're Purdue, what you're thinking on the sideline, this offense, you're saying, guys, we've got to come out here and close this ball game out. If you're on this offensive line for Purdue, you're thinking, this is on our backs. And I see the guys down now. They're huddled up. Guys are speaking, talking about just that. Can you come out here and close this game?
Onside kick coming up for Nebraska. 3:27 left. Now, it's been a wild second half here at Ross-Ade Stadium. Purdue clinging to an 11-point lead. Nebraska will try here for an onside kick. The Huskers have not attempted one this season. And Nebraska still has 3 timeouts. And if you've watched Nebraska at all this year, strange things happen when they take the field. This one bounces up, and Purdue able to recover. Brendan Fitzgerald tells us what's coming up next. Should provide some interesting visuals.
Good time. Good time, and certainly if you like to people watch, you're in for a treat.
Delicately put. Markel Jones tackled after a gain of 3, 2nd and 7. Timeout Nebraska, so the clock stops with 3:22 to go. Purdue led 21-9 at the half. The Boilermakers took a 42-16 lead into the fourth quarter. Well, the Huskers have outscored the Boilers 22-7 here in the final stanza, and it's 49-38, Purdue with the ball. In the fourth quarter, fourth and one, Purdue decides to go for it. They decide to throw. Incomplete, so Nebraska gets the ball back down 11. Little pinball wizard, it ends up with Frankie Williams. And then on the very next play, Markell Jones in for the TD. Nebraska comes right back down the field. Riker Fife to Brendan Riley. And it's 49-38. This is Jones again. He's to the 41, about 4 yards shy of the first down. Nebraska uses its second timeout, 3:17 left. All right, I'm on your Darryl Hazel, third and four. Is a pass option even on the table?
Yeah, I think so. I go back to a play where they converted on a third down early in the third quarter, where Blau is on a boot. And there are a few passing options, but he makes the wise decision and runs for the first down. If you're Darryl Hazel, try to get him on the move. Give him two ways to go. We've seen today that this young man is athletic enough to beat you with his feet. That's the case. He's rushed for 82 yards today. He's averaging 8.2 a pop. I think you put the ball in his hands, and as we said earlier, this young man is continuing to grow and mature, and let him make the decision on whether it's better to run or whether it's better to pass his football.
Blau has been the man for Purdue. 28 out of 43 passing, 274 yards, 4 TDs through the air, 1 on the ground on a 56-yard run back in the first quarter. They'll run it. It's Jones. Surges ahead. And he's going to be just shy, so it'll bring up fourth down. The clock will run. And Nebraska uses its final timeout. So the Huskers elect to stop the clock with 3:07. All right, Ahmad. Fourth and one. Is this an easy call for Darryl Hazel? Do you punt it away? We were in this situation about 5 minutes ago, and he went for it.
I mean, Nebraska still needs two scores.
Two scores, right?
So if that is the case, maybe you try to pin them inside of the 10 with an outstanding punt, you know, get some good hang time on it. But, you know, I'll say this too. With the way that things have gone for Purdue today, they've really fell their way. They have. I mean, you make an ill-advised decision, like I said, on fourth down. You come back, your defense gets an interception. You score on the next play. Look, if I'm Darryl Hazel, what I'm thinking right now is maybe it's our time.
But how many times do you go to that well?
I don't know. And that's the million-dollar question right now. And as they're sitting around pondering, I know Darryl Hazel right now, maybe one of the more important decisions he's had to make all season long regarding his team.
I only say that because the guys on the other side are due to catch a break.
That's true.
Not that any of this is science. But when you bring it down back to football, fourth and one, 36-yard line, 3:07 to go, you know Nebraska has to score twice.
Just checking the spot here exactly to see where Jones went down.
They
can't
are
really
reviewing
see there.
The spot.
Let's see if that knee gets down soon. That knee's down already. Yeah, it looks like he's a tad bit short.
All right, so back to the question. Call the field stands. It's fourth down. What is the call by Darryl Hazel?
I think you punt. I think it's the safe move, and especially since you didn't go, and it looks like right now, well, they've still got their offense on the football field. And, you know, well, and the one thing that you could do here is because you're Purdue, you do have a timeout left. You can go out here and try to draw Nebraska offsides to get the first down. Maybe that's something that they're thinking here. But their offense is out on the field. Whether they go for it or not, Darryl Hazel and his staff and his team may be judged by this play alone.
Oh, they are going for it. It's a gift to Jones. He's got a first down. And that should seal it for Purdue.
And that That's why they pay them the big bucks. You know, it's because those types of decisions, that was tough. And now, if you're Nebraska, you're just hoping for a fumble. If you're on that side of the ball, you're trying to hold up ball carriers, rake the ball out, anything you can do to get the ball back to your offense. And if I am Purdue, this is about running the football regardless, because you can milk the clock at this point just by running the football.
Nebraska is out of timeouts. Jones, one cut. And pushing ahead inside the 25, he breaks free. Jones to the 10-yard line.
Wow. I mean, he just gets lost in the pile and comes squirting out of that thing. I'm not sure how Jones here. I mean, the entire team nearly on here, and Jones just will not go down. He makes that one spin move. The Nebraska defenders were probably waiting for a whistle. They don't get one because that pile is still moving, and Jones does a smart thing by falling down in bounds. Now you've got that clock moving, another first down. This looks like that might have been the sealer for Purdue.
Credit that offensive line. All five starters back from last year. And that unit has played well today. As Jones spins to the 7 seconds here, Brendan, and then we will get you out to Vegas. Can't wait to see that. Vegas on Halloween night. Meanwhile, for Purdue, Coach Hazel told us this would be a resounding win. Purdue has not won a Big Ten home game since Hazel arrived. Jones reaches into the end zone, and that'll punctuate it for the Boilers.
The student section scoring crazy. They're jumping up and down. You know, this has got to be an exhilarating feeling. You come out here, and I know that this is not the old Nebraska, but when you beat a program like Nebraska and you're Purdue and you're trying to get over that hump,
this is the biggest win that Darryl Hazel has had.
This could be something that really changes how you see yourself when you look in the mirror as a program.
Went after is blocked. That's a live ball, folks. There is a flag on the play. Nebraska is going to run back the block kick for a two-point conversion on their end, but there is a penalty marker. Now, was that a forward lateral?
The illegal forward pass.
Oh, there it is.
Defense, number 24. That foul occurred before the try is no good.
Take one more look. Kick is blocked by Jamal Turner. Aaron Williams got it. And yeah, from that angle, Stanley Morgan. Yep, there it is. Just for Morgan tries to sell it by bringing his feet back.
No question.
So the 2 points come off the board for Nebraska. Point after, no good. No re-kick, since all that happened after the kick was blocked. And now Purdue will kick it off. 55 points against Mike Riley. Now, Nebraska's been close in its previous five losses. They could never get to within less than two scores in the second half against Purdue. There were times where momentum swung their way and you thought maybe they could make a push, but they couldn't get that stop. Purdue's offense was able to convert some big plays and some big third and fourth downs.
Yeah, and that defense gave them more opportunities by creating takeaways. And the more possessions you can get, you increase your chances of scoring. And when you have an effort like Purdue did today, where you're getting contributions from your special teams, your defense, your offense, it's really hard to beat any team at this level when they're clicking on all three cylinders.
Turnovers, the main narrative. Nebraska committed five on the road. Remember, they were starting Riker Fife, first career start for the junior. Tommy Armstrong injured Nebraska lost its starting running back, Terrell Newby, to a leg injury. That was in the first half. And DeMorne Pearson-L was carted off the field in the first half. You piecemeal that together with what was already a banged-up defense, and you add in five turnovers, it's not a good recipe. Ethan Carter gets out of bounds. Ahmad, how does 3-6 play in Lincoln?
Not well, you know, but like I said, I think they've been competitive, and I don't see, if you really look at their body of work, it's hard to say that this coaching staff hasn't done the best with what they had when you look at injuries. But I think this is one of those wins for Purdue, you know, which they're the story of this ball game, that this could really change the momentum in the program, help with recruiting. Not only that, the players' confidence changes when you win a game like this. So this is a monumental victory. I know it's a Nebraska team that's struggling, but for Purdue, you can walk away with here with your heads held high and think to yourself, we are finally starting to turn some corners.
The folks here in West Lafayette are excited about a plan for a $60 million football facilities upgrade. They'll break ground in May. At least that's the plan. And the facility expected to be completed by August of 2017. Well, it's great to be able to sell that, but at some point this coaching staff had to sell wins.
Yeah.
And wins had to be the barometer of progress. Today was a big step in the right direction. Westerkamp reversing field. Still on his feet. And into the end zone. They want to keep playing.
What a great effort from Westerkamp. Wow. I mean, now you can see why this guy is the go-to target. Jeez.
Nebraska out of timeout, so we'll have to attempt an onside kick, and they'll need almost an improbable series of events to occur to have a shot here.
Yeah, Nebraska's still in this thing. They're still fighting. Despite the scoreboard, you've got players out here that understand that right now is where you really show pride in your work, when you're down. And things aren't going your way, and they have not for this Nebraska team really all season long. And so to keep fighting at the end of a ball game like this, I think it shows the integrity of these young men and this coaching staff.
Riker, 407 yards passing. Four touchdowns in his first ever start, but he was haunted by five turnovers, including four picks.
Yeah, it just wasn't the start that this young man would have wanted, and it's got to be disappointing for him. He's a walk-on. He gets his opportunity to finally play. He's been sitting behind Tommy Armstrong for the last 2 years, and then you come out here and you don't have your best performance. And so despite the fact that today didn't go well for him, he's finally got some things on film that he can look for and work towards.
Onside kick. Nebraska saying they've got it. And the Huskers do. Tyron Ferguson recovered it for Nebraska with 30 seconds left.
Yeah, and that ball didn't go 10 yards, but the Purdue person who's trying to protect the kick here on Hand's team comes forward, and that is why they were allowed to recover this football. And sometimes that's a difficult play to make. I've played on these Hands teams. It's a difficult decision to know, do I chase the ball? And at that pace that it was going, I think it was the right decision, but you've got to secure it once you get there.
So 28 seconds left. Huskers not going down without a fight. Fife flushed. Gets away from Hudson. Floats one downfield. Incomplete. He wanted Hovey. Nebraska scored 29 points in this fourth quarter.
Jeez. Wow.
Nebraska in danger of losing six games before November for the first time in school history. Purdue rushes three. Fife in trouble. And down he goes. Panfield the sack. And that should do it. Darryl Hazel gets his biggest win as Purdue's head coach. The Boilermakers win a conference home game for the first time under Hazel. Meanwhile, Nebraska falls to 3-6. For Ahmad Brooks, Simon E. Schrapp, we say happy Halloween to you. The adventure continues in Sin City.